It's a tough world out there for future dietetic students like you, and I know from personal experience as a dietitian, but former, of course, dietetic student, that I really needed help and support in this time because I was really just focused on finding how I can make myself look the best and put my best foot forward for these internship applications and for DICAS and for grad school applications. Today's topic is going to be specifically on your personal statement. This is a really important paper that we write to our internships that we're applying to show them that we want their program and that we're good enough for their program and that we're a good fit. So I just want to talk about some of the things that I used to help me along the way and some of the advice that my professors gave me along the way, because they really truly helped me get an internship. I truly believe that without them, I would have had such a harder time navigating this. So I want to make it easy for you and I want to help you navigate this tough time and this stressful time so you can get into the internship of your dreams. So let's hop into it. I have my tea ready and we're just going to look at some of the notes that I have on my personal statement and just some thoughts that I gathered together. Just to give you a little background about me. So I've been a dietitian for almost 2 years now, I think. Can I do math right? I graduated from my internship in 2017 in December. And from grad school at the same time. It was a combination program. And then in March of 2018, I took my RD exam. So not quite 2 years, but almost 2 years at this point. I did get pre-selected for my internship. So if that gives you any kind of idea of how well I guess I did on my application, then maybe that says something. I'm not here to brag, but I just want to share that with you so you can know that I feel like I did a pretty good job on my application, so hopefully I can help you too. I know exactly how you're feeling, so I'm gonna be looking over to the side because I have my laptop out, because this is one of those like videos that I feel like I can't do off the top of my head. I have to have like a little bit of notes. I'm just that type of person, you know? I just can't, I miss the days of PowerPoints where I can just look off the PowerPoint and like read my notes. So I'm bringing back school for you girls and you 3.8% of men out there too. So this is for you. Okay, so my first tip for you guys is to not repeat your application. So you're gonna have your DICAS application and then you're also going to have your personal statement and then your other application stuff. The application and the DICAS application are gonna be things that show you, or show them rather, your objective talents. They're gonna share the things that you've accomplished and the things that you've done, and then they're gonna say, hey, that chick's pretty cool, or that dude really rocked it in his summer internship for the food pantry. You know, these are gonna show them objective facts about you, but it's not necessarily going to show them your personality or your passion or anything else. I mean, I guess you can argue that objective talents and objective things measure that, but I think people in these internship programs and the professors are really looking for good fits. So don't just regurgitate the same knowledge that they got from your DICAS application. Make sure you show your personality within reason in your personal statement. You don't want to come off inappropriate necessarily or immature in the fact that you overshare, but you want to share enough about yourself that they really feel connected with you when they read your application and when they read your personal statement. So if on your DICAS application you said that you volunteered for, I'll just throw it out there, Girls on the Run. So that was something that I did personally and that I had on my DICAS application, but all they know from the DICAS application is that I did it and then maybe a few lines of details, because you really don't go into that much detail in that application. In your personal statement, you can bring that up again, but tell what you did or tell what that meant to you or how that impacted you as a future dietitian. So what I did with Girls on the Run is that I was a assistant coach. So I ran with them, I did activities with them, and I helped the regular coaches, but I also ran a few lessons on body image, and that was something that really made me feel all warm and fuzzy inside and something that I was hugely passionate about, and that's one of my reasons for becoming a dietitian. So you could include something like that in there and how it impacted you and how that really is going to propel you as a dietitian to make an impact on other people's body image in the future, or making lessons for a community setting based on body image and self-esteem and building confidence in the world of, you know, Instagram and Snapchat and all these things that kind of make us feel worse about our bodies and other social media platforms. The other thing is don't be too vague. So I see a lot of people be hugely vague about everything. So I see people be hugely vague about, say, like, they're passionate. Like, tell us why you are passionate. What makes you passionate? No. Don't tell me that you're passionate because you want to be a dietitian. They already know that. You're applying. Tell us what makes you passionate. What burns your fire? What makes you want to get up every day and change lives? Like, tell us that. Tell us the deep shit. Without going too inappropriate, but there's a fine line. If you are confused on what is appropriate versus inappropriate to share, comment below and I can try to help as much as possible. I'm not, you know, like a professional at applications or anything like that, but I'd love to help you in whatever way I can. And you can also DM me on Instagram at darkbluenutrition. Find me there and follow me there and I will answer all your questions. Okay, so the next thing is to show off your uniqueness. Now, I said something about not just being vague about it, really going into detail. And this also goes with sharing about you a little bit. So tell them why you're different than other applicants and why you stand out among the crowd. Again, you don't want to just lean on the fact that you were a really good student and that you were really committed to volunteering. Those are great things, but you wanna show them why you would be the best possible fit for their program. You want to be the Lady Gaga of applicants so they remember you and that you really stand out. Remember, these are so, so competitive. So the more that you can stand out to them and the more they can think back to, hey, who was the one that said this, this, and this on their application? They really got to me. They really like struck a chord with me. You want to like pull on their heartstrings a little bit. While of course being honest and just open and being true to yourself, you want to find a way to make them remember you. So one example that I would use for myself is that I gave some examples of the educations that I've done in the past and how I felt after giving those educations and after impacting those people and like how it made me feel inside. And then I also shared what I plan to do in the future as a dietitian. So I really made sure that I focused on programs to apply to that were community focused, educational focused, or like a nutrition education niche. Those were all the programs that I applied to, and I ended up applying to 4. I think I was going to apply to 4 and then I got pre-selected, so the last one I didn't end up applying to. But I applied to 3 programs, but all of them had that niche, so I knew that I was being true to myself, and so I could honestly tell them that I was super passionate about this and that I would be a good fit for that reason. Which leads me to my next tip, which is make sure that you and your program are a match made in heaven. So if you are stuck on how many programs to apply to, I would say about 4 is what I've typically heard from professors and people that do the matching process. They say that 4 is about like the max you should apply to because of just how the matching system works. And I'm not gonna go into that in this video because it would take far too long. But you wanna make sure that you apply to not just random programs, you want to apply to the programs that fit your niche and that you feel they would like you and you would like them. If you are not happy with one of your programs that you're applying to, don't apply to it. I know like that sounds maybe harsh or that maybe sounds like I'm telling you to give up certain things, but I think the more you focus in on ones that serve you and that you can serve them, then you're gonna find that your match rate could increase or your likelihood of getting a match rate could increase. So if it looks like you're being super generic with your personal statement or that you didn't even talk about their program or how you fit with their program in your personal statement, then they're probably not going to be interested in you and you're going to be low on the list of the applicants that they consider. Unfortunately, with the way DICAST works and the way the matching process works, that can hurt your chances of getting into other programs just by the weird formulaic thing that they have going on. Make sure that you only apply to ones that you want to go to and that you tell them why you and them are a match made in heaven. This is like kind of the last touch points that I'm going to share with you guys. And just some overall things that I caught while I was looking at my personal statement and my friend's personal statement and just like thinking about what makes a good personal statement. So there's 2 more parts of your personal statement that most personal statements require, which is your strengths and weaknesses, and then also your short-term goals and your long-term goals. So starting with strengths and weaknesses, you don't want to BS this. I know sometimes this is an uncomfortable question to answer, but you want to answer honestly, and you want to share with them what your true strengths are. Don't be shy and be confident. Tell them what your true strengths are. If you're not sure what your strengths are, then make sure that you go to a friend or a family member and ask them what they think your strengths are, and then go from there. Chances are you already know what your strengths are, but if you need a little help, that's one way to do it. As an example, my strengths were being a compassionate person, a dedicated and passionate person, and also an intuitive person. So those are what I feel my personal strengths are and what I have heard maybe from other people. So I explained a little bit more in detail of why I thought that those things were my strengths and how I could apply them to the program. Then when it comes to your weaknesses, you want to point out your weakness and don't lie about it. Don't say you have no weaknesses, or don't say you're just a workaholic. Don't say one of those cliche answers. You want to give a true answer and then tell them how you're working on it. So I believe mine was something along the lines of being easily overwhelmed sometimes in certain situations, but I told them how I was working on it. So I said that I meditated regularly, I was doing yoga, and I had a support system to reach out to when I was feeling those feelings, and so I didn't feel like that would ever get in the way of me as an intern. I definitely got stressed out as an intern, I will tell you that much, but I was right and I did have a support system and a way to manage it while I was in there, so, you know, all is well. And then for your short and long-term goals, what do you want to do in the next year or so after you become a dietitian, and what do you see yourself doing in 5 to 10 years after this? So I was totally honest with them and just told them that I wanted to do video educations. I said that I wanted to work in the wellness field, maybe like a sports nutrition focus or something like that. And I feel like I did all those things, no big deal. So just be honest with yourself. This may take some time to think about what your true goals are, but just, you know, we're goal-oriented people in the dietetics world, so you can think of these easy. Oh, and if you have any extra information that you need to share with them, like something that's on your personal record, or maybe that you dropped out of a class, or that you failed a class and then you retook the class, if you have any extra information that you need to share at the end, you can do it at the very end. And keep it very short and concise, and don't, you know, dwell on that thing if it's like a negative thing. Just disclose it and then maybe close up on a good note. But don't dwell on bad things, but they are sometimes important to point out if you have something that's on your record or something that, you know, you flunked a class or something like that. But that is basically all the tips I have for you today on how to build a better personal statement. How are you feeling about your personal statement now? Are you ready to rock it this year? Are you ready to get that internship? Or are you feeling still uneasy about certain things and you have certain questions? Make sure to comment below and I'll try to answer all your questions. And again, if you want to private message me and it's not something that you want to disclose to the YouTube universe, then you can DM me at Dark Blue Nutrition on Instagram. I'd love to chat with all of you future dietitians, and I wish you so much luck on getting your application approved and getting the internship of your dreams. Make sure you tell me what videos you'd like to see in the future on this topic or on any nutrition and fitness topic, and I'll leave a playlist of all the RD2B videos in the description box and also at the end of this video, so you can check those out and get as much knowledge absorbed in your brain as possible. So I will see you guys in the next video. Bye guys.